In 1843, there were beautiful roses in the garden of the sisters of St. Joseph of Das in Cartas, Habit, in the north of France. Everyone admired this garden, which had beautiful roses that bloomed to live for God alone and in the service of the women. And then, years later, some of them grafted themselves and landed in India to grow. Ever since, new life continued to emerge, and today, you see before you, there are fully bloomed roses, aging from 70 to 103 years.
Wow! How beautiful they are even in their old age. I am lost in their beauty.
Hi! What are you wondering about?
Yeah, I am admiring. Well, you said they are between the age of 70 and 103. I am inspired by their faith, spirit of audacity, dedication, spirit of sacrifice, hard work, faithfulness, joyful spirit in the service of God and His people for so many years of their lives without drooping. I think they are grown and nourished. This SJT was started on the granite of sacrifice and calling you and me, the future generation of the SJT, to follow in their footsteps.
Yes, I too have realized this. For whenever they were called, they were ever ready to uproot and plant themselves where the Master Gardener wanted them to be. Yes, they understood the saying, bloom where you are planted. Oh yes, these are the beautiful roses that has bloomed in the SJT garden, spreading the fragrance to all in the SJT family and to God's people across the world.
I have seen them blooming and spreading their fragrance in various ministries. Pastoral, faith formation, education, social medical, community service, and at the call of the medium. Today, as we celebrate your day, we want to acknowledge your exemplary life of commitment, dedication, sacrifice. And we thank you for passing on the legacy of the SJT Foundation to us, the future of the SJT family.
Yes, sisters, you are the beautiful roses blooming in the garden of Jesus. By leading a charism of Trinitarian communion, you add beauty to yourself by fulfilling the plan of the Master Gardener, Jesus, by offering yourself generously with self-sacrifice without counting the cost. Though at times you might have been tried by fire. We are here right now to acknowledge with gratitude for the life lived, for all your services, and for your praying ministry. We pray that you continue to bloom where you are planted now and spread the fragrance of God's love. Today, we, the budding generations, will carry on this mission of Jesus, the Master Gardener, by your prayerful support, guidance, and encouragement. We promise to live with awe and fear and carry on the spirit of faith and zeal.
So here we are, dedicating this song for you as a token of our love and gratitude.
Happy.